Hey everybody, welcome to Altium Academy. Thanks for joining us. I'm Zach Peterson. I'm a technical consultant with Altium. And today we're gonna talk about test points. Now, we got a great question from a viewer who was interested in understanding how test points are affected when they carry a high-speed signal or if they're being used for some sort of test with a high-speed component that needs to source a lot of data at high speeds. So let's take a look. Paul Butich writes, "Dear Zach, I absolutely love your content. Your video about to pour ground or not to pour was fantastic because it shows all sides of this topic, which many see just as black and white." Thanks, Paul. That's what we try and do around here. "I'm a young hardware engineer at a young startup, and we're going into production next year. Our fabricator said for ICT testing, we should have a test point for every net on our PCB. It was really tough to get them all in one small PCB, especially with the high speed signals. I have some bad thoughts about test points of 0.8 millimeters in the net." So Paul, you bring up some great points. Now, you can actually designate different structures on your PCB as test points, depending on how you need them. They can be pads or they can be vias. And there's actually a tool inside Altium Designer that you can use to designate different structures as test points. Now, as far as what happens with high-speed signals, this actually relates to another topic called stubs. And depending on how you arrange your test points or if you're adding them manually, you could create a stub on a high-speed line that could create a signal integrity problem. So let's take a look at both aspects of test points, whether it's at low speed or high speed. What exactly are test points? Well, a test point is used during manufacturing to check the electrical status of a net in your PCB. So you can use it for continuity testing. You can use it for like a resistance test, which is essentially the same thing as a continuity test. You can use it for a high potential test, which is essentially measuring the breakdown voltage of your board. You can use it for other more specialized tests, or once you get the board back from manufacturing and you have it in the lab, you can use test points yourself to probe different nets on the PCB just for your own testing purposes. So it's really common to designate test points in the board and make sure that they're going to be available for access either by you, the designer, or by your manufacturer. So let's just say that we have a component on our board and you know, it's got some pads around it. So this isn't the prettiest component, but you kind of get the idea. But essentially what you could do is you could actually designate one of these conductors if you wanted to as a test point. Now, assuming this is a surface mount component, the problem is that these would be covered by the actual leads of the component. So it's really not so easy to access for in-circuit testing during assembly, but you could designate this if you wanted to as a fabrication test point. So just as an example, let's just say that this pin went to ground and this pin also went to ground. Now, you could actually check in electrical testing that these two pads read zero resistance between them because you can see that they're both connected to the same net. So that's a pretty basic continuity test. And that's one of the things that you're checking when your fabricator does electrical testing. The other thing that you can do is if you want to have one of these pads accessible during assembly or, you know, for you yourself, the designer, if you're doing any kind of testing, what you can actually do is you can create a small pad that comes off of this particular pad. So this is where the component will mount. You've got a trace coming off of here. It leads up to this test point. You could then probe this and some other feature in the board. I don't really care what it is, but you could probe this and some other feature with a meter, and then you could actually measure the electrical behavior. So this could be sourcing a signal, like this could be part of a bus, or it could just be outputting a constant voltage, whatever it may be. You'll know the test that you need to do, but this is what gives you access. So that's a pretty easy way to do it. Now, with high speed, if this comes off in this direction, what happens here with this portion of the net? This portion essentially acts like a big stub. But now the question that you have to ask is, does this stub really matter? Well, it depends on the input impedance as seen right here along this portion of the net. Now, if this stub is short enough, then it's essentially not gonna matter. This pad is basically like an open circuit, meaning this pad is generally, when you place pads like this, they're not meant to be connected to anything specific. They're basically just infinite impedance with respect to ground. So if I were to measure, you know, between here and here, then I would measure infinity with a voltmeter. It would overload the voltmeter. Here at the input, if you can keep this pad close enough to this trace, then what's going to happen? Well, this open circuit here is not going to transform the input impedance to some other value. So this is a more complex topic, and it relates to transmission line termination with stubs, and that's something that we'll have time to look at in another video. But just note that if you are dealing with high-speed test points, the test point itself shouldn't be placed too far away from the actual signal here. So another type of test point that you can put onto a board, and that is actually really useful if you need to like provide access for like an oscilloscope probe, is it actually looks like a little hook that just mounts onto the board with surface mount. So those little hooks are really nice because you can, again, just hook on a probe, it will stay hooked on there, and you can get a measurement that way. You can do that with an oscilloscope or like with high voltage systems, you can actually hook on just a voltage probe and take a measurement that way. Those types of things essentially work in the same way, like this. They just come off of the net, maybe they're referenced to ground, maybe they're open, depends what you need to do with it, and you can then just latch on and take the measurement that way. How do we actually designate all of these different areas in our PCB layout as different types of test points? So this is where you have to actually do something in your CAD software. Now you could manually type up a big report and say, you know, this pad on net, you know, whatever the net name is this type of test point. But what you should actually do is take advantage of the best CAD software, because inside of your CAD software, as long as it's, you know, high quality CAD software, you'll actually be able to designate specific points on the board as either a fabrication or an assembly test point. So let's take a look at that now. Okay, so what I'm looking at here is one of Mark Harris's projects, and I'll actually link to this project in the description. But what I'm showing here is the 3D view. And so as you can see from this 3D view, we don't really see any obvious test points that are designated in this board. This board was not set up with any specific test points. So if I open up the tools menu and I go down to test point manager, you can see here in this menu that none of this is actually designated for test points. That's okay. You may not have to do this, your manufacturer may do this, but if you want to do this, you can actually do it inside Altium Designer. So I'm just gonna show you how to do that. So let's say I hit two and I go back to the 2D view. Let's just say for a moment that I want to designate this particular via as my test point. So if I go to the properties panel, you'll notice here on the right down at the bottom, I can click on fabrication and assembly. And then here with the solder mask expansion, I just want to make sure that it's open on the bottom. And now I've just designated this as both a fabrication test point and an assembly test point, okay? And I wanna make sure that it is untented because this is a via. So that's important because here, if this is untented, it will actually be accessible when you go into fabrication. So here, let's just take a look. Flip this over real quick. So you can see right here, it's untented and it's visible. Someone's gonna be able to access that with a probe. Pretty simple. You can do this with, you know, pretty much any via you want. You can untent it on the top or the bottom layer. It's just kind of up to you. All you just got to do is go in here, click on the via or the pad, whatever it may be that you want. Scroll down here to the bottom in the properties panel, and then you can designate it. So just for an example, you can designate it as a top assembly and top fabrication test point. So I make sure that this is unchecked right here for tented. And then just wanna make sure that we have here with our manual exposure, 0.6. So we'll make it quite a bit smaller. Okay, so if you look at this and then you look at it in 3D, you might say, hey, that's a pretty big test point. Why is it overlapping with this pad? Well, here if I go into 2D, you can see that this is all actually part of the ground plane. So there's a bunch of copper pour on this top layer. It's not a plane layer, but there's a bunch of copper pour on this top layer, and you can see that this is all the same net. So you don't have to actually make it this big. You can make it, you know, much smaller if you wanted to, whatever it needs to be. Here, then when I go into 3D, you'll be able to see the pad. And so this will be accessible as a test point during fabrication and assembly.
So what we've been talking about so far applies pretty much to any kind of net where you need to do continuity testing. But what I want to do is kind of look at where this might arise in a large processor like an FPGA, which might have some high-speed interfaces on it. So here you can see I've got differential pairs running off of this BGA. You can see they're located along the edge, so they're really easy to access. And then they just route up to a bunch of connectors. Down here in this little net right here, this is actually a test point that's used on a GPIO. And then you can see it goes, you can go through an internal layer, through a via, and then back to one of these pins. What you don't see on these differential pairs is you don't see pads coming off the side. So why is that? Well, these differential pairs are carrying high-speed signals, and we don't really want to use these stubs off the side to do any kind of continuity testing if we can help it, just because that has the potential to interfere with signal integrity. And so you can see up here on this connector block that we've actually got some spots where we can use these as fabrication test points, because these are through holes. So you can see right here, I've got through holes, and these can be used to actually test continuity on these traces for this differential pair. Okay, so that's pretty good. What you wouldn't do during actual testing, like on the line, like let's say you're doing, you know, functional testing, is you wouldn't actually use these for really high speed stuff. Okay. And that's really important. You wouldn't be transmitting a bit stream through these differential pairs at high speed and then coming off here on a pad like this and then trying to actually test these and do like signal integrity testing while the board is in operation on the line, or if you're doing some kind of functional testing on the line. So that's going to be something that you as the designer have to do during the prototyping stage. Now, there are test fixtures that you can put onto a board, or like with this connector block, if you had another test fixture you wanted to connect to this and do functional testing on the line, you could do that. But you wouldn't really do it with these little pads coming off the side as test points, okay? So that's a really important distinction. Don't get the impression that you can just throw like a little pad like this or like this coming off the side of one of these differential pairs and use that for like signal integrity testing. So that's something you should be aware of. However, there is something that you can do with RF, and I bring up RF because you're operating at one particular frequency where you might, let me zoom into one of these pairs, where like on this trace, you might come off the side somewhere in here and put a UFL connector to then connect to a mini coax cable, and that could go to an instrument to take a measurement while you're actually running the equipment. So that's a little bit of a different case because you're putting a stub in, but it's operating at one specific frequency, and then that's going to couple into a connector and go to some other piece of equipment. So just keep that in mind. Don't think that you can just take signal integrity metrics off of like one of these little pads coming off in parallel off of one of these really high speed channels, because these are designed to run at gigabit speeds. One of the exceptions to that is like really low speed USB. You might be able to do it. I've never done it with low speed USB, and you can do it with like low speed Ethernet. So 10/100 Ethernet, you can get away with it. 10/100 Ethernet is actually really forgiving on signal integrity as long as you're doing stuff over short distances. Once you get to gigabit and higher, it gets a lot more challenging. So just keep that in mind when you're placing test points. We prefer something like this through hole to do some kind of continuity testing, just because I can access this from the backside of the board if I need to, just when I'm debugging, or during fabrication and assembly, it could be accessed on either side of the board.
So hopefully that helps you understand a little bit about how to designate test points. It's really easy to do in Altium Designer. And if you have a situation like this, just keep in mind about where you set the test point, especially if it's if you're dealing with like a high speed or a high frequency signal. Generally, you wouldn't want to put this type of test point like this on a high speed signal unless you're bringing it really close. That way, this is not going to modify the input impedance of this interconnect looking in this direction during operation. All right, everybody, thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit that like button. If you want to see more of these videos, hit that subscribe button. Leave your comments and questions in the comments section. Go check out a couple of the blogs in the description also. They're going to detail how test points are used in manufacturing, and you'll be able to access that project from Mark Harris on Altium's blog. Thanks again, everybody, and don't forget to call your fabricator on this one.